sabi nga ni Doc Abel, it's the fastest growing breed. Mm. And it won't be labeled as that as such kung hindi siya friendly sa family. Kasi kung napakarami na sanang bad incidents about the American Bully breed, hindi ito lalaki ng ganito.
And nakikita natin na ano, it's even gaining speed and momentum.
Oh yeah,
pa.
We're only starting.
And you were telling me a while ago, yung importing ng mga new dogs, no? How frequent is it now compared to before?
It's funny you asked that, Doc Abel, kasi sabi ko nga sa mga kwentuhan ng pagka may bully talks kami, no, which can go on forever. Pag nagsimula lang alas 7 ng umaga, dun pa lang natatapos ang bully talks kasi sobrang interesting sa amin yan. No? Mm. Nung siguro sabihin natin 10 years ago, 15 years ago, pag may nag-import sa Philippines ng American bully from the States once in 6 months, 10 years ago, happy na kami. Why we're happy? Because one in 6 months, meron kaming bagong aso na makikita. Aside from that, may bagong asong magkakaroon ng lahi dito sa atin. Kasi, di ba, ini-introduce pa lang sa atin. But now, almost every week, there is a new import coming from Europe, coming from China, coming from America. When it comes to this breed, ganon na siya ine-embrace ng family, ng community dito sa Pilipinas. And it's becoming a global breed. Why did I say that? Before, kilala siya sa America, of course, no? Sobrang laki niya doon. Tapos, na-introduce siya sa Philippines, Thailand, and then siguro Spain. Yan, mga household names ng countries na kilala sa American bullies. Lately, yung buong Europe, boom na. Yung UK, they hold the record for the most number of entries in a show. Mm-hmm. I think they hold the record of, I'm not sure kung may 400 to 500 dogs in a show. Now, purely American bully lang. Mm-hmm. And it doesn't happen everywhere. And considering it's a new community, UK is comprised of course Ireland, yung mga nasa London, and then mga Scotland, di ba? Siguro, hold lang sila, wala pa silang 6 years. And then lately, Doc, yung China had the boom. And ngayon, Russia is introduced to the breed. So imagine how the breed will explode if China and Russia, which before was absent 2 years, 3 years ago, and now they're there, edi lahat ng, di ba, sobrang global reach na yung American bully talaga.
Oh, oh. Let me ask you this. Mm-hmm. How does it affect you personally that this breed is gaining in popularity, gaining in momentum?
Doc, I cannot stress enough how happy I am and how proud I am, because I can consider myself as a pioneer, of course, here in the Philippines, one of the pioneers. Sobrang dami namin nagsimula dito. Sabi ko nga, may mga taglaylo, di ba? Meron pang active. Ako talagang dumiretso lang. Proud ako kasi, you would say, can you even imagine saying na parang, I am one of the pioneers of the Shih Tzu. You can't say that because it's been established for how many hundreds of years, di ba? Pero at least, I can say na part ako sa pagbibuild nitong breed na to, itong American Bully. So, whoever is planning to have American Bullies, you're actually being part of the pioneer people na nagsisimula dito sa breed na to. And who knows, 50 years from now, kung ano na yung kinahinat na nitong breed na to. So, maging proud kayo dahil palaki ng palaki talaga yung breed.
So, would you say that the breed is still evolving when it comes to characteristics, looks? Dahil a lot of breeds started out looking differently than they are today.
Yeah.
Would you say na what is the direction of the breed when it comes to yung mga parameters that you're breeding towards?
I have two parts ng sagot ko sa question mo, Doc. No? Personally, I would prefer sana that the breed can stay this way. Yung looks niya is, for me personally, yung looks na nakikita ko ngayon, yung best dogs in the world, kung yung looks lang nilang i-judge ko, satisfied na ako doon. I just hope it gets maintained, yung ganung looks. Pero, like you said, almost all breed evolve into something else, whether we liked it or not, whether it is our plan or not. Of course, we're just human. We don't really stay in this earth forever. So there are people that will probably decide eventually to change it. But if you will ask me personally, I will not want it to change anymore. Kung ano yung, kunyari, meron tayong ililabel as perfect American bully right now in the world, I want that look to stay forever.
Oo, kasi may mga additions to the breed standards. Iba, like right now, I think they are smaller than pocket bullies.
Yeah. If you may, I will try to explain a little bit. There are 4 classes lang naman ng American bullies, no? Mm-hmm. Mabilis lang is Standard, Pocket, Excel. Those three, actually, and then the other one is Classic. Those first three, they should all look the same except height. Alright, so strictly speaking, technically speaking, those three, Pocket, Standard, and Excel, ideally speaking, the difference should only be the height. Alright? When it comes to Classic, ito yung medyo mukha pang old school, ang tinatawag nila. Meaning, medyo may mukha pa siyang Amstaff and Pitbulls. Kaya siya Classic. Hindi lang siya nawawala pa ngayon dahil sabi ko nga, bata pa yung breed. So, nandyan pa rin yung Classic. Pero itong tatlong American Bully class, they should all look the same. Mass, bone mass, body mass, muscle tone, big head, blocky muzzle, except the height. Pero, I am also acknowledging the presence nung new style of bully, which is the exotic bully. Parang ganito lang yan eh. Let me say this para maging klaro sa lahat ng viewers, no? Before may pitbulls, di ba? Maraming may gusto ng pitbulls, maraming may nag-appreciate ng pitbulls. And then, nagkaroon ng konting evolution. May mga set of people sa States na mas prefer nila yung pitbull na hindi masyadong payat or hindi masyadong muscular yung rip-rip muscular. Mm. They want it massive. So, gumawa sila ng sarili nilang timpla, itong mga Amerikanong to, na eventually tinawag nilang American Bully. And then, their desire to have it recognized as a separate breed eventually came to fruition. So, dog community in the world right now, it is a known fact that American Pitbull Terrier, American Staffordshire Terrier is different from the American Bully. And maging proud dapat yung pioneers dyan. Kasi naihiwalay na nila ang American Bully breed sa Pitbull breed. It's not that they don't like this. Mm-hmm. It's just a different breed. And now, here comes a new one. Exotic breed. Mm-hmm. Exotic Bully. It just so happened, Exotic Bully has just been introduced, sabihin natin mga 8, 7, 10 years max. Of course, it's a relative of the American Bully, but it has a way different look. So what I hope, it's different look, different mix na rin yan. Ibang breed na rin ang mga mix niyan. Iba rin dito. May that's why
ibang breed na
rin. Ibang breed na rin ang hinalo diyan. Yes, meron silang lahing American Bully, pero hinaluan pa sila ng ibang breed para breed ma-create yun? Kasi they want smaller, they want more bulldog breed. So, I can only speculate because I don't know exactly. Probably French Bulldog, probably some Bull Boston, something.
Boston Terrier.
Whatever. Pero, I can only speculate because I wasn't there when they created that. Ang gusto kong mangyari sana kasi is parang history repeat itself. When the pitbull community said, oh, pitbull lang yung American Bully, pareho lang yan. No, eventually it became a separate breed. I want the Exotic Bully to be recognized as a separate breed eventually. Na hindi na nila pwedeng sabihin na yung Exotic Bully nila is an American Bully because it creates confusion. That's my wish for the Exotic Bully community. Whether it will happen or not, I'm not sure. And I am not part of the parang planning process for that. But kung ako lang, dahil may konting history tayong pinagbibihisan, sana ganun. Kasi Doc, yung Exotic Bully community, majority of them came from the American Bully community. So most of them are also my friends. I just want them to have a very clear delineation of this is an American Bully and this is an Exotic Bully.
Yung mga large, ano naman, yung mga extremely large bully dogs, anong classification naman yun?
We have the XL yun. So, kung meron tayong Pocket is the smallest, which is below 17 inches, sa standard is dapat ma-reach na yung 17 inches until 19 inches. Pag umabot ka na ng 20 inches sa withers mo, yun ay label ka na standard. So, 20 and above, yun na yung mga matatangkad na bully. They are called XL. Kung meron ka namang nakikita na parang katulad ng Dog Dynasty, something sa States,
Si Hulk,
which is labeled as Pitbull, some experts, some purists ng Pitbulls will dispute actually yung pagiging label niya as Pitbull kasi it's not the usual size ng Pitbull. So, whatever breed was infused to Hulk before to have or to achieve that height, I'm not sure also kung ano, but
parang bandog na siya.
Parang ganon, di ba? So, I agree with you. Pero for me, it's just labels, but some people will of course be very particular to that and sa akin, as long as they're loving and they're promoting their dogs in a positive way, I fully support them.
So you have no animosity towards those gravitating to the extremes?
Yeah. Nothing at all. Kasi, Doc, parang ganito lang rin yun, Doc. Share ko lang. Kilala ako sa Philippines as ABKC because I'm the leader for the ABKC here in the Philippines. I am a senior judge for the ABKC International. If there are clubs coming here in the Philippines, not associated or affiliated with ABKC, as long as you're promoting promoting the American Bully Breed. Mm. You may not see me having a placard promoting your show, but I will not say anything bad about those clubs because, uh-oh, again, they're still promoting the...
If you're not against us, you are for us.
Yeah, if you're not against... they're promoting the American Bully Breed. All I want here, my main purpose is to promote the American Bully Breed. They're doing it, so I'm happy for them.
You mentioned that you're an international judge, no? And I've seen your social media that you go to different countries, mm-hmm, and judging shows there.
Yeah.
That's amazing, no? A Filipino.
Thank
and you,
you
told
Thank
me that you're the only Asian who's doing this,
yeah,
judging.
Yeah. If I may, I'm the only Asian living in Asia as a judge. Kasi mayroong mga Asian judges living in America and Europe. Parang ganun, di ba? Parang may lahi sila. Pero just to be very specific. Anyway, yes, ako lang yung Pinoy, ako lang yung Asiano na nasa Asia ngayon, right now, na international judge ng ABKC. It's not my liking, it's just the way it is right now. Wala pang nakuhang another judge, international judge from our region of the world. But we're trying to work on it. Yes, last November 2019, the biggest American Bully show, which is the ABKC National, was held last November. And ako yung pinalad na napili na mag-judge on that biggest event. Mm-hmm. So I'm very proud as a Pinoy, as a Filipino, na ako yung napili na mag-judge dun sa napakalaking...
How did it go?
Oh, it's so enjoying and sobrang nakaka-proud, pero hindi ko akalain sa sobrang dami ng dogs, almost 400. During the night, after the show, my legs were numb. Talaga, as in, hindi ko siya maigalaw sa sobrang sakit. But sabi nga nila, it's the labor of love. And sabi ko, alam ng tao to, ng mga nakakilala sa akin, mahal ko yung breed. So any hardship na ma-encounter mo talagang...
How many days was the show?
It's just a one-day event, but it only happens every year, yung tinatawag nilang ABKC Nationals. Pero sabi ko nga, Doc, sa sobrang laki ng community na to, let's just go micro. Here in the Philippines, every month, there is a local show.
Mm-hmm.
Siguro 2 to 3 shows locally held in the Philippines. Meaning, when I say locally, local shows is, syempre, dito local lang siya ginawa, hindi siya affiliated sa international. Meaning, hindi siya ABKC show. Guided lang siya, for example, ng mga ABKC standards, pero sa Pilipinas, Doc, sa Feb 16, I think, meron. Tapos, within February also, sa Jensen, meron. Baka sa Cebu, meron. Ganon ka-in love ang Pilipino sa American Bully community. Ay, sa American Bully Breed.
Wait, let me clarify. Yung ABKC is the international club.
Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
So, it's the internationally recognized mother club of all these other clubs.
Yeah, in a way, it's the original.
Mm.
It's the mothership, kumbaga. There's no regulation whether kung merong magpatayo ng sarili nilang club. We can build a club if we want. And name it as Manalo Bully Club and nobody will tell us we're doing it wrong. Marami dyan dito sa Pilipinas. Siguro meron tayong local clubs dito sa Philippines, mga 4 to 5. No? And they're doing it to promote the breeds. Oh, I'm very thankful, kahit hindi pa sila ABKC.
Kaya ano, daming proud sa'yo, no? Because you're the international judge and you're representing the country to sa bully community,
Thank
even
you.
Abroad.
Thank you.
How did you get to this point? Anong parameters or qualifications?
I told you a while ago na merong time sa Philippine community wherein parang almost dead na. So, nung napagpatuloy ko and then na-invite ko sila, eventually yung ABKC, si Dave Wilson, went here and he noticed my leadership capabilities siguro. Because I was the leader for the National Pitbull Terrier Club back then, and then we were able to facilitate and have this biggest show, and it's sanctioned by American Bully Club. When I say sanctioned, is there is a judge from ABKC judging that event. Yun yung parang ginagawa rin ng PCCI, right? They invite, or the ACUPI, they invite the judge internationally, and then and it's recognized by their point system. Ganun din sa Philippines or sa ABKC, hindi yan madalas. So, to make it short, nung na-invite ko sila, nakita nila yung leadership quality ko, sabi nila sa akin, John, I see you as one of the leaders. Would you want to apprentice as a judge?
Mm-hmm.
So I did online study, book study, I did exam, I did interview, I went to Indonesia to apprentice on their own ABKC show. Nag-apprentice ako sa mga judges nila doon. And then eventually, another exam and another interview, and then eventually, I passed. It wasn't given to me on a silver platter. Pinagtrabahuhan ko siya, and then I went outside the country through my own pocket, through my own money, para lang ma-achieve ko yung gusto kong ma-achieve na maging judge.
And I think it has proven to be a very fruitful endeavor.
Oh, yeah. because without the chance of being a judge, I won't be hypocrite. That without the chance of being a judge internationally, I won't be able to probably visit Italy or USA or other countries in the world na ganun lang kadali. So I am fortunate and I am thankful. Pero talaga, ang thankful ako talaga dyan is yung Philippine community.